At the solemn request of our new king, the royal geomancer has determined that the new capital of the Shang dynasty is to be at a site that shall henceforth be known as Zhengzhou. It will be located on a hill overlooking the river. To ensure the security of the city, engineers have already been at work on the city's fortifications. Use the guidelines of Feng Shui to help locate an appropriate site for the king's palace. Establish an elite neighborhood of lavish xie wands and designate one or two wards for common citizens. Bales of hemp must be procured through trade, as it cannot be grown here. Fortunately, there are other cities looking for wood and ceramics. A ferry will provide access to the abundant deposits of copper ore on the far side of the river. The bronze will be of use not only for bronzeware, but also for weapons. Begin training and equipping some infantry without undue delay. You just might need them, as barbarians covet the riches of our land.
Hey guys, welcome back to Emperor Rise of the Middle Kingdom, and we're now here on the walls of Zhengzhou, I think I pronounced that right, and it's looking for 20 people in modest Sihir ones or better, one allied city required and population of 1,300. But that's not really the difficult part, it seems like it's going to be a military mission, and we've got some trading to do, and even some of our raw materials, copper ore, is on the far side of the river, and we're going to be attacked by barbarians. So let's head on to the city and pause the game here. So let's have a look around at what's actually going on. It seems like we start with some defensive walls here, actually, which is quite nice. That's a good start. I guess we're going to be building mainly inside these walls, but let's see. The copper ore is down here. And they also wanted to build... there's some... What are these? Crocodiles? Salamanders. They wanted to build... a monument, I think it was. It's not under fortification right now. It is, let's see. Here we go. No? It asks for a good place for Feng Shui for... What was it? The palace. Here we go. Oh, so we gotta have good Feng Shui for this palace? I guess it should be inside here. Okay, so let's check our raw materials here. Let's go to agriculture. We can have cabbage, millet, and wheat. So we got three types of food to grow right here. We can get mulberry trees, silkworm sheds, and fishing keys. So we've actually got potential to create four different types of food. Oh, no. Three different types. Cabbage and wheat. Millet is for hemp, I'm pretty sure. Wait, no. I'm a bit confused. And let me just check here. I'm back on agriculture. We have a farmhouse. Okay, yeah. It's all three types of food, so four types of food. But that means we can't produce hemp, I think that is. We might have to import that. So let's go to the empire map here, and we've got the nomad camps, Baoji, Banpo, Bo, and Kufu. And generally, I'm going to have to find out what they want. So I'm going to have to get this started, set up a residential area. I think the main residential area could fit inside here. I think it can, along with the expensive residential area. Industry, I think it might have to go down maybe along one of these rivers. We could go down here and set stuff up here. We could also go down this path here and set stuff up here. If we're going to be attacked, I'm going to imagine we're going to be attacked from this open area here, which is a little inconvenient because this is sort of the best, or sort of best stretch for farms. Oh well, I think I'm going to put industry down here, agriculture up here, and maybe a little bit down here as well. And then all the residential stuff in here. So that should be good. So let me plan some stuff out and let's get started. All right, here we go. I've got a basic plan here, and you can see my residential area. I put it inside the city walls where I've fit as many houses as I can in the single block. I think this road is not too long. It's 10 houses in a row here, which means it's 20, 20, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 here, 20, 20, 40, 46, and then 52 walking tiles here. I think that's not too long for the market ladies to, and just general service providers to walk around and still complete a full circle. Some ceramics industry out this side to the southeast in to produce this stuff. I thought this was a nice safe place. Sima Biao of Bo proposed that we begin trading with each other. That sounds like a good idea. And I set up a ceramics industry here, and I also set up the ferry to get some bronzeware going along over on this side as well. Then I went down the back way here to reach this little fertile plains where I'm going to set up these farmhouses where I messed up that tile. I might move that farmhouse a little bit later when I got more money, but I split the farmhouses to growing all three crops at the same time, just so it's not too focused on each one. So this one, for example, cabbage begins in August, millet begins in July, and wheat harvest begins in July. That means it's currently March, so it's going right now. So that way I'll split the workforce, but right now I just need people to move in. And let me check the Empire map here. We're trading with Bo. They produce hemp, perfect, which means we should probably just start importing hemp right away. I'm gonna pause the game. Let's go to commerce, trading stations with Bo. Let's find a nice place. I suppose right here is perfect, actually. I'm gonna put it right here. And I want to import just a little bit, like 8 units of hemp. That will help my houses evolve, because I always had problems in previous missions where I tried to grow hemp and I always forgot to grow hemp and had to wait for the seasons. But this time, well, if it's I can import it, that shouldn't be a problem. So I've reached 100 people in my booming city, and we just gotta let these houses evolve. So yeah, I'm gonna wait for these people to move in, let the houses evolve, hopefully our food industry, I'm not sure if we're producing enough food here, but it should be okay. And just checking the religion tab, we have 3 neglected gods, Nuwa, Shennong, and Huang Di, which we'll have to do something about later. We just gotta get some people in first. Alright, there we go, we've got some food coming in, and we're starting to feed these people, which they need plain food before the house can improve, which shouldn't be a problem because we're bringing in multiple types of food. And this food shop here, we should be aiming for plain food so they can evolve straight away. Yeah, but we did place down a few more houses down here which we could squeeze in, and I put down this herbalist stall just so people don't start getting sick. And this is I could actually squeeze in 2 more houses here, but desirability from the market might be an issue, so I'm not putting them in just yet. I want to see if I can get enough people in from here. And if we have a look at, it's the new year, Gong Xi Fa Chai, but we still need more people to move in. We should probably put religion on high there, it's just a couple extra people. But my industry and commerce still need a lot more people to move in. And I also put down 1 more farm here, leaving a gap for me to move this farm 1 up later. I'm not sure if I'm producing enough food here. And it does take a while for these cart pushers to push their food into there. Perhaps I could put a road here, and I'll let them decide if this is a faster way to get into the city. Maybe it is, if they walk around that way. It might be slightly more dangerous if invasions do come from this northwest bit, but getting food in is quite important. And there we go, we've got some plain food coming in, and need access to music in order to evolve. That shouldn't be a problem. I think I could just stick the music school right there, and that should be fine. And we're starting to evolve these houses a little bit, but I do kind of want to evolve the quality as much as possible in one shot, and I think We are producing enough food now that I've put down another farm here. And you can see the distribution of food makes them allows them to focus on what they're working on. So we're currently on fully staffed here because I set the priority for agriculture to be high, because it is really important to get this food stuff in. But we are producing... Yeah, I think we're going to be okay here. Now, just got to wait for some music to show up here. Music is quite well employed. I just want to see... Then the appeal of the neighborhood needs to increase. Okay, so now we do have to start worrying about making some money. Bo itself is desiring bronzeware, which might be enough to get us started, but we should probably just find out what the rest want by sending out diplomatic requests, open trade. I'm gonna request to open trade with everyone and see if some people accept. But even if they reject the request to trade, they will actually be okay with... they'll let me know what they actually want. So bronzeware is being produced, but not at a rate that I'd be happy with. We got plenty of clay in, but not enough bronze, which is coming from here. This bronze smelter, which is sort of producing okay amounts, but I don't want to put down a second one until we're actually getting proper employment here, but maybe I should just go ahead and put down a second one straight away here. I don't want to block the path. I'm going to put it there. Have the road come around this way. There we go. Two bronze smelters. That should get things going, at least for one export. And then we got to find out what other exports we need. Currently, we need 52 workers. I could raise the wage rates a little bit. That should get industry going. Now, these houses can't evolve until the appeal of the neighborhood increases. I think I won't spend too much money on more gardens here because I'll just put down some, see what happens. And they need appetizing food before the houses can evolve, which is three types of food. So I'm going to wait until the food supply stabilizes, and I'm going to set this to desire plain food for now, because I don't want the houses to evolve too much, because people are actually coming in now. Let's lower the wage rates. We've actually got unemployment now. Okay, good. So with unemployment, we can start ramping up our industries. And these salamanders, are they going to cause any issues? No, they're not like crocodiles from Pharaoh, are they? No, they're okay. So looks like distributing up to three crops at a farmhouse is ideal. It looks like we get to pretty much maximize our harvest here. You can see that. It looks amazing. Oh, the salamander is like crocodiles. We got to deal with those. I'm not sure how. But yeah. Meanwhile, I'm pretty sure our gods are... they're still feeling neglected, which is not good. I gotta be wary of that. But I gotta start ramping up production of everything else. Now, that house is having some issues. I'm gonna put down a couple gardens there for its benefit. Okay, so I'm gonna try stabilize our food supply and ramp up our production of exportable goods and see if we can actually start making some money, because I'm starting to run out here. All right, here we go. We've got two new trade routes. Yes, the Wei River allows us to access Baoji, which is a water trade route. We got to be careful of that. What do they buy? Rice, ceramics, cabbage? They do buy ceramics. Banpo, they buy fish, wheat, and carved jade. Damn it. Khufu wants wood, hemp, bronzeware, and silk. And the Nomad Camps want silk and wheat. Okay, so I would like to start selling ceramics, but it's a water trade route. And, I'm not sure exactly how that works. Baoji water trade route. Let's go to the city. I've not actually explored. Well, there we go. Trading key. Trading key with Baoji. Oh, it's big. Oh, but luckily it fits right here. Oh, that's fantastic. I can just click it right here and it'll be fine. Let's push it over to this side so it takes up as little space as possible on this road. I'm gonna place it there and I'm gonna start selling ceramics as much as possible. And we are actually getting some bronzeware coming in now, which we can see it's being transported over to our trading warehouse there. So, is there a way for us to ramp up bronze production? We got plenty of clay going around. Could we ramp up our ceramics production? I think we could. I think there's room for one more kiln. Where's good feng shui? There we go, we'll just put it there. And we should try ramp up our bronzeware. Gonna put two more of those down, and I'm not sure if how many bronze smelters we need for this. Currently I've got two. Perhaps I should go for a third one, I'm not sure. I should also start... during the briefing it mentioned I should start producing weapons. So let's start producing weapons as well. They also need bronze. So that's gonna take up some of our industry. I'm gonna put down another bronze smelter right here. So we have three bronze smelters, and we got this weaponsmith, and we gotta put that weapon somewhere. Let's accept it there. We don't need too much space for it. We'll just stack four into there. That should be fine. Okay. So, meanwhile, our food supply is sort of okay. This first feeding is always the roughest part, so we gotta wait a couple years to see if we actually manage to feed everyone here. And I'm not sure if the market lady is actually walking far enough. I'm pretty sure if she turns this way, it should be okay. I'm not sure if they're not walking far enough or we're just running out of food. It's hard to tell at this point. And ooh, looks like we got plenty of wheat coming in, actually. We got, how much space we got for everything? 8 for each. That's sort of limiting our space here, but that should be okay. We'll see what happens. Okay, here we go. We've got our first water trade route coming in here. Lotus Blossom, trading Zhong from Bao Ti. So we've loaded up on ceramics here. We're just about running out of money, and let's see if this actually manages to save us. And I think it does. Look at that. It's more than 1,000. Oh, it's like almost 1,500.
Make sure you pack those goods in tighter next time. We've got to make a profit off this junk.
Yes, exactly. And I also just noticed that these ferry landings, it actually says the ferry landing is sending sampans across the river. Sampans, that's what we call it here in Malaysia. Anyway, food supply is starting to look a little rough, actually. And maybe it's a distance, maybe it's just not bringing in enough types of food in one go. I set down two food shops, but I'm not sure if we're actually... Yeah, we're not feeding the people, as you can see here. They need plain food to grow, but I set the minimum quality to bland food, so at least all the houses will evolve to this level, and at least we know that the market lady is actually covering the whole residential area. But we do need more workers here. We're a little short because these houses did devolve, and we're not bringing in enough types of food. There we go, we got two types of food coming in. Some cabbage with this millet should cover it. So I'm gonna set the minimum quality to plain food now. And probably to... I should probably wait. I'm not sure if that's enough food to actually get things going. I think it is. I'm gonna destroy one food shop, and I'm gonna put down a new one because... Oh, do I want to hold a festival? No, not this year. I'm gonna put down a new food shop so that it resets what it's taking. And there's two types of food, so that should help evolve these houses back up. Okay, so money doesn't seem to be too much of an issue now. We are selling some bronze as well.
On my way.
Yes, so ceramics weapons also coming in. We should probably set up a bit of a military now. Infantry fort. I think, I'm pretty sure that they're going to attack from here. Why can't I place it? Oh, I need an administrative city first. Okay, let's pause the game and see what we actually need to put down here. Let's go to government and administrative city. Where would be a good spot for that? I'm expecting to use this lower space for... the expensive housing, so I don't need to place this anywhere too relevant, really. I could just tuck it away in the corner like that. That's an efficient use of space. That's probably a good idea. Otherwise, I could put it around this side or just tuck it into that corner. I don't think anything's going to be going into this corner, so I'll probably put it there. I'm going to make a bit of space there. Put the administrative city right there. And I'm going to extend the road out, probably just from here, and roadblock it. There we go. And just have a road go along like that. And I'm pretty sure it does need an inspector's tower as well. So inspector's tower, somewhere with good feng shui for the inspector's tower? No? I'm not too sure where I could put this. Well, maybe for the inspector's tower, I just need to unblock that, because the only thing that's walking that way around this side is the inspector's tower. So okay, maybe he'll just walk over that way and alternate between these two roads, and hopefully it doesn't collapse. But since we've got that, we can actually put down a tax office as well. It might be worth taxing them. Let's go back to government, tax office. It does fit there quite nicely. And we'll need a bit of wood. Am I accepting wood right now? I'm not. Let's accept wood. Just 4 units. There we go. And we could put down... Let's see. Where's the logging shed? It should be under industry, right? Raw materials, logging shed. And we can just place one. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. No, that's not good. Ah, we can just place one right there. Okay, we got a logging shed down. So, just checking our feng shui here. Let's see feng shui. Everything is in the green. So it's looking fantastic. Yep, everything's in the green, so... That should be good. And now that we've got an administrative city down, we can have a look at our military infantry fort. It's only going to cost 150. So where can we stick this? What does it like? I saw it turn green just now for a second. No? I'm pretty sure I saw it turn green. Well, I'm gonna have to look around and see where I can actually... Oh, there we go. We can actually place it up here. Do they like trees? It seems to like trees. But not... I'm not too sure. I don't want to place it too close to the edge of the map. Ah, we can actually place it up here. Right by our city gate. So that would be a good spot. And these trees sort of provides it some cover. So I'm gonna place it right here. And it does need road access. So there we go. So we're gonna start building up our military, which is good because I think someone will start marching on our city relatively soon. And as you can see, our housing area has actually evolved back up. We got some millet and cabbage in there, so that's a-okay. Alright, I'm trying to transfer over to appetizing food, so I set the minimum quality to appetizing food while it's full of wheat. And that means cabbage and millet are currently being farmed and should be harvested relatively soon. There we go. One's being harvested now, cabbage soon after. And I also put down one more farm here just to increase my food production. And besides, I had some unemployment anyway. Actually, my unemployment is at 10%. That's lower wage rate, so if people stop working. That doesn't make entirely full sense, but never mind. All our industry is looking pretty good. Our ceramics and bronzeware making is going along quite nicely. We've got some infantry coming in, so we got some military over there. And I think these houses do have enough food supply to last, just to wait out until appetizing food does come along. You can see there's like 30 to 40 units in each one, so that's really nice. And I should actually start looking at my review goals here. I've got population. I need an allied city. Now, the city that wanted to trade with me is Bo, and I'm not sure how I can improve relations. Is there any way to look at, let's see, I could request alliance with them, but I've been trading with them for a few years. I sell them bronze, I buy from them hemp. Not sure how we can tell. Oh, right, pay homage to an ancestral hero before they get really angry. They're all unhappy here. So what can I give here? I got, can I actually give hemp? Because I'm importing that, and I do have cash to spare. I got ceramics, so definitely let's give some ceramics. I'm just gonna, I don't know, medium crate to Nuwa? Yeah, so the next 3 months I've gotta get these gods happy with me. Alright, there we go, we've actually got appetizing food coming in, and these have evolved to elegant dwellings, and they need an acrobat house before they can evolve, which I cannot provide. So this is the maximum level that we can provide, and look, we got three types of food in our mill here. I also put down this extra inspector's tower because this mill actually collapsed at one point because this inspector is walking over that way. Do I want to hold a festival? No, not this year. We're still balancing our food act here. But we're still also trying to get these gods happy with us. They're feeling quite neglected and unhappy here. But I also did ramp up my ceramics production because I got to start giving the ceramics to these gods. So I put down two more kilns and one more clay pit, and I think we're doing okay. This kiln over here isn't doing anything. Maybe I could actually afford putting down one more clay pit, because these bronzeware makers also need clay. Perhaps that would be a good idea. Let's put down one more clay pit if we can find a good feng shui spot for it. Maybe somewhere. Oh, one can go right there, I guess. Yeah, it should be fine. One more clay pit there. That should keep our clay supply coming in. Now, let's go back to religion. This guy's unhappy. Let's give him a medium crate of ceramics. There we go. Shen Nong's unhappy again. I just gave him some hemp last time. Gotta give him something nicer. Anyway, things seem to be balancing out quite nicely here, and this extra farm should provide enough food, and it's also a lot closer, by the way, so it's supplying food at a much faster rate. So I could start planning putting up our Modasihirwans and try to get our allied city. 20 people in Modasihirwans, I'm not sure how many people fit in each one. Let's see, elite housing. But there's plenty of good feng shui down here, which is good. Remember last time we did elite housing, it was a bit of a mess. So I think I can figure out how to do this. I just gotta get a row in here somehow, and I'm not sure if we should... We should probably put down a second market as well. Oh, this is convenient. Well, not convenient, actually. Khufu is asking for 4 bolts of silk in 4 months. Unfortunately, I have not... I've just set up my silk industry. I put down one farm here. It fit quite nicely in that corner. And I put down 2 weavers on this side. And this is not that good of a... I'm gonna roadblock that. It's not that great timing. I should have put this down a little bit earlier. I kind of forgot about it. I was just thinking about elite housing and how they need silk. So that's not so good. At least it is at least season for these things. I'll get a bit in, but I'm not sure if I'm gonna get enough of 4 vaults of silk. Let's see. I should. Yeah, it's currently accepting raw silk. I think that's all we need. Yeah. So this mulberry stuff or this, is it balls of silk or raw silk? Raw silk, jade, platinum, house, half jade. Yeah, okay, it should be raw silk. I only see one thing to do with silk. How's that infantry fort going? Soldiers. I think they're going okay. Stored weapons. I've only got one weapons producer here, but I'm not sure how big an army will be attacking us. Meanwhile, I was also looking at. This tower status, we can actually man these towers. Currently they're not manned, so they're not taking up any employees, but that's something that we can do. And unemployed workforce 89, that's 12%, that's set wage rates are very low. And because we actually have too many people, I should actually boost my industries even more. Yeah, because I've been giving a lot of ceramics. I think we also sold a bunch of ceramics, we're making a ton of money. We've been giving a bunch to the gods, but they're all neglected and happy now, so we should be okay. They're not unhappy. So, gonna boost silk, and the next thing up is to set up this elite housing, which I was gonna do just now until I was interrupted. So, let's give this a shot. Okay, here we go. We've got something going, and if you see here, I actually put this red residential wall along this military wall, because I think that military wall is bad desirability. But what was that notice there? Khufu demands silk. Oh right, the 4 bolts of silk, which I don't think is going to be coming in time. You can see here, sending 100 units of raw silk. It's definitely not raw silk. I don't want to get raw silk here. What are we actually producing here? This raw silk cocoons before it weaves any cloth? Is it called cloth? Cabbage, game meat, rice, with it, bronze, rice, raw silk, carved jade. Oh, there we go, silk, there we go. It's not raw silk, it's just silk. There we go, okay, good. So, how are the gods doing? Neglected, happy. No one's gonna be cursing us anytime soon. And we've got this down. So it starts with hemp and ceramics, and I put down another market square here, as you can see that. Here we go, one guy's moving into the elite housing. And I think it said we needed 20? 5 occupants, 1 too many. That's strange. There's 6 people living in there. But they need appetizing food before they can evolve. And I'm not sure if we're actually bringing in enough... let me try put down some basic amenities here. I also want to put it down one by one, so I can actually understand what they're looking for. So let's put down a food shop here, and it needs appetizing food, minimum quality. So we'll get that set up soon enough. They also need hemp and ceramics, definitely. Job vacancies, do we actually need more workers? One worker needed? Let's set our wage rates to low. 9% unemployment. Let's keep it at very low. One worker needed is much better than 9% unemployment. But let's also put down a ceramics shop and a hemp shop. There we go. So that should provide the basics. Hemp is fine, ceramics is fine, so we're not short on any of those. How's our military looking? Military looking okay. We have forces in city. We have 9 men as the audacious snakes. So I think we're doing okay on that. No one's threatened to invade our city yet. And here we go, 2 other types of food coming in. That should provide the appetizing food once this millet arrives. And we needed how many people in these things? 20 people. So when this evolves, I'm going to see if it still is 5 or 10, because if we can only need 2 of these things, then that's going to be much more convenient. And of course, some things, the design is a little bit weird just to fit feng shui. That inspector's tower has to go over there for that bit of rock over there. But everything is still green on feng shui, so we're doing good. No problem there. So going to wait for food supplies to come in, hemp and ceramics to supply quite nicely, and see if we can actually evolve these elite housing. Alright, there we go, we've done some reorganizing here. I shifted this marketplace over here because it actually collapsed, and when I tried to put it back, it was different feng shui, I think because I removed a tree or something like that. So I had to place it over here where it's still good feng shui, you can see that, and it also has the inspector's tower walks through it now, so that's much, much better. So, I've got that going. I have also put down one more mulberry farm here and put up an extra couple weaver's studios over here with this inspector's tower. Employment is not an issue. I've still got 36 unemployed here, so that's no problem. But that's going to boost my weaving production, which is currently abysmal. Meanwhile, we should check on the gods. Who's unhappy? Please neglecting. Let's get Nuwa happy here. We've got ceramics. Let's give a medium crate of ceramics to Nuwa. There we go. Money is still coming in, lots of bronzeware coming in there, and lots of ceramics being sold as well. Look at my residential area, everything is filled up here. That house over there can't evolve because of the appeal. Looks like all these gardens doesn't make it nice enough. Never mind. I wish I could have actually paved these roads. There are aesthetic roads, but they take two tiles, which makes things a little bit inconvenient there. Oh, the Xiongnu army of Shanyuhu Hanye, leader of the nomad camps, is approaching and will try to invade the city in 9 months. Okay, so let's pause the game, check the state of our army here. Do we have decent troops? We have one set up here.
Ever vigilant, ever prepared. We are ready for any war.
Yes, let's, how do I send them back to the... There we go, going home. I should put down one more infantry fort just in case. A palace is required to build more forts. Oh, I see. Okay, so let's go to government and write this palace. This is something that they were asking me to build in the briefing. So let's go ahead and place this down. There we go. Ooh, look at that palace. This building cannot access the labor pool. Don't worry, a menagerie for types of animals as well. Just to make it look nice. I'm gonna surround it with gardens. There we go. That looks nice. Yes, good. So, now that I've put that down, I should be able to place one more infantry fort. I think. I've got a palace. Is it working? Okay, now it's working. Good. So, good feng shui. Where can I place this? Let's clear that out. We can place one right there. And we're not really producing enough weapons. We should probably put down one more weaponsmith. To boost our production of weapons to get some infantry going. 9 months is a pretty short amount of time, so I'm gonna prepare as much as possible. And ooh, some job vacancies. 23, let's raise our wage rates, get things going again. There we go. So, we're producing weapons here as much as possible, and we've got two infantry forts, and we will be manning these towers as they approach. I'm not sure if that actually... If they attack from this angle, that's going to be a bad place to have an infantry fort. Let's try to find a better spot for it, like along here somewhere. Oh look, I actually have enough bolts of silk to dispatch to Khufu now. Okay, dispatch now. Finally, I have enough silk. Ah, well, looking this ramping up of silk production here should be good enough. It looks like we are actually having the four weavers going at it. That should be good. Two weavers per farm seems to be an ideal amount. And, oh yeah, the salamanders are still causing problems. I gotta deal with that soon, but we are gonna be invaded anytime soon. So I also set the tower status to manning. So as you can see here, there are people patrolling the walls here, and these towers should actually work as well. So I'm banking on the fact that they're gonna invade from this angle. That seems like the most likely place they're gonna invade from. There's a small chance they could come here and walk up this hill as well, but I don't think so. Meanwhile, my elite housing looks like upgrading to modest Sihir ones is gonna still only be 5 occupants. I'm gonna need 4 of these things. So let's go ahead and put down one more. The nomad camps will attack in 2 months. Okay, I'm gonna put down one more of those. Oh, I don't have enough hemp. I gotta import more, I think. Yes, I've traded 12 out of 12 this year. So I'm just gonna boost this up to 12 now. To make sure it is always full. It's December now, so once January rolls around, we should be able to import more hemp and put down 2 more elite housing. And we also need an allied city. So we've been trading with Bo this whole time. So let's send a diplomatic request and see if we can ally with Bo. And if not, well, I guess we'll just give them more money and get them to like us that way, through bribery. Anyway, they're gonna invade anytime soon. Let's prep for battle. Okay, here we go. The Xiongnu army from the Nomad camps is here. Surrender, lose game. Let's go to site of event. And oh, damn it, they're invading from there. Okay, fight to defend the city then. New Year's, I do wish to hold. Do I want to hold a festival? No, let's not hold a festival while we're being attacked. Okay, this is inconvenient. I prepared for defense on the wrong side. Let's get our troops over then. Just got two in this fort, but it's better than nothing. Okay, I had no idea. They're not even gonna wait around. They're just gonna go straight at it. Well, at least our towers are actually fighting. Doesn't look like there's too many of them. Ah, damn it, they're actually starting to attack our city here. Stop killing my industry. Okay, here we go. Start fighting them. There we go, infantry has arrived. Let's hope they don't destroy any buildings. That would be inconvenient. You guys, go. Bo has rejected your plea for an alliance. That's fine, that's fine. Okay, here we go. Kill the remaining horsemen. You guys, walk over there. Don't let that two-unit infantry deal with them. Okay, come on. Last guy here. There we go. Great news, Gamerzak. Crushed by your forces, the weakling soldiers of the Nomad camps are in full retreat, led by the embarrassed ruler Shan Yu Huhanye. Your city is safe. Wonderful. Let's return our soldiers back to their forts. And if they want to come back again, I'm going to have twice the number of soldiers. And everything is looking fine. Currently, I've got unemployed workforce, so I think I'll leave my tower status as a manning. And we still need to get... We still got to get an ally. I guess Bo is the best chance here we've got. Let's give a gift of... What do they need? Ceramics? We could start giving them gifts of ceramics as well. How much ceramics do we have? We have plenty of ceramics. Wow, okay. So let's... give a large gift of ceramics to Bo, and that should get them happy with us. And let's check our gods. Contented, please, contented. That's no problem. Our silk production is in doing quite well as well, actually. And it is the new year. Where's all our hemp gone? Oh, the traders haven't reached here yet. Okay, so there we go. There's the traders. Once the hemp comes in, I'm going to put down the two last elite housing. Then we just gotta get an ally, and hopefully Bo will like us after this large supply of ceramics. Alright, there we go, we've got four modest Sihuans over here, and they're all doing fine and dandy. So that's one more thing going for us, and we just need one allied city and we're gonna win. So I'm waiting for Bo's response to my ceramics, they definitely needed it. And we had a bit of a hemp shortage here because these houses actually started devolving. You can see that they needed hemp. And ooh, joyful day, Gamerzak. I, Sima Biao of Bo, thank you for your amusing gift of ceramics. You realize, of course, oh, did I give them the wrong thing? Did I read that wrong? Bo, they sell ceramics. They need bronzeware and carved jade and rice. Okay, damn it, I gave them the wrong thing. Let's give them bronzeware then. A large gift of 16 bronzeware. Do we actually have 16 bronzeware vessels? I got 400 there, 800 there. It actually takes out of our trading post, does it? Let's let him put that there. Okay. Bow. Okay, bronzeware. Let's... Oh, there we go. That's how we see how people feel to us. Apathetic. Everyone's apathetic. That's fine. Okay, Bo, let me give another gift. Sorry about that. A gift of ceramics. Let's give you a large gift of bronzeware because that's what you actually need. Ah, there we go. All the bronzeware sent out. Don't worry, we're producing plenty. So, gonna wait for their response to the bronzeware, and everything else seems pretty stabilized. And this last check on Feng Shui, everything is green. Yep, everything's fine and dandy. Perfect. Looks fantastic. Okay, how's our employment doing? We're unemployed now. Let's leave it like that. Okay, good. So, we'll wait for Bo's response and see if we can win the game. There we go. Oh, great, Gamerzak. Bo really appreciates your extravagant gift of bronzeware vessels, which they sorely need. Okay, there we go. Now, how do you feel about me now? Admiring. Okay, fantastic. Now, let's send a diplomatic request. Actually, let's send you another gift. Let's send you a gift of 1,000 strings of cash. So I'm going to send that off. And once that's been sent, I'm going to wait a month. It's now October. It's now November. Okay, after that, I'm going to very quickly request an alliance with your city. And that should seal the deal, sending you an extra 1,000 strings of cash. And look at this, our industry is all booming, and our employment is going very nicely. 4% unemployed, some people moving in. I could probably drop the wage rates to balance it out. 32 workers needed. I'd rather have some unemployment, make sure everything's running in tip-top condition. Okay, gonna wait for their response and see if we can win the game with our new request for an alliance. There we go, there's the monetary gift appreciated by Bo. Let's see how what they think of us. And now, that's still admiring. The rival thinks very highly of you. Is this the highest we can go? Admiring? He'll probably be willing to fulfill your request for food, and he might even fulfill requests for goods. Continues to feel this way, might one day swear fealty for you, provided your military is stronger than his. Okay. So let's see if our alliance request goes through. And there we go! Haha!
You built a new capital with wisdom and protected it with vigor. Like a young tree in a fierce wind, you weathered the first storm without breaking. Those Xiong new horsemen were a determined foe. Sadly, I fear it is not the last we will see of them.
All right, there we go, the walls of Zhengzhou here, and there's our score. And it's relatively straightforward mission, though these walls are sort of an introduction. I think they're giving us a nice, smooth learning curve up into military here, because I think the previous games were sort of very confusing, but Emperor is sort of teaching the ways of military here, step by step. All right, well, everything went well in this mission. No monuments to build, so that made it a little bit easier. But that's all for this episode. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.